Yeah, I know. I started doing it like that, and then you change. Yeah,
yeah. Yeah,
I'm gonna go take a shower. I'll come back.
Thank you. Something
back there. Oh.
I can't work in these conditions.
What do you got there, mate? Go ahead, don't worry about that. There's all this crap at my house.
Oh.
Of Shania's. It's been sitting there for months. Just take it. Oh, she's got heat lights.
I don't need heat lights. They need heat mats.
I'm not angry. Stop saying I'm angry.
Sorry.
Thank you. can replace their teeth for up to 3,000 times. Now that hole starts off really small and it gets bigger when those teeth get bigger as well. Now we'll move on to their bite force. If you take a look on either side of our bite force machine, we've got a bite force scale. All the way down the bottom we have us humans. We have about a 20 kg bite force, or equivalent to dropping a stack of potatoes on you. Also imagine if that was your wrist, you can.
3, 2, 1.
Perfect. As you can see, that ice source is demolished. When we are feeding him, we are asking him to do a push up. That is a jump. So these guys know common commands like, good boy, come on, dig up, and their name. We teach these guys that. So then we can communicate them to ask them to do something. Now as you can see, he's doing a nice lovely smile for us. Now when these guys are sitting on the bank, you might notice they open their jaws up. Or if they're sitting on the water, they sometimes open their jaws up as well. Now this is to regulate their body temperature. These guys get really hot sometimes or really cold. So when they open their jaws up, they're regulating their body temperature to either cool themselves down or warm themselves up. As you can see, our zebras are backing out slowly. This does mean it comes to the end of our roosting time, but lucky for you guys, we'll be feeding yet another crocodile. But to give our zebras some time to get ready for the next croc, we're going to head over down to William Cape and have a quick chat about them.
A little bit boring in the water, so I'm going to clean their teeth just so that we don't have to. They will go and start to lose their teeth, and they will go and start to replace it with some lines. Very white. Now what are you doing for us? What we call a water drop, and it's when they're sitting their body underneath and leap up and out of the water. These guys can get as high as their back legs out of the water. Then you take a look at how long they live. If you imagine them jumping out of the water to the back left, it would be quite wide. Now, when he does any water jumps, he lifts his head up. That is his enabling it. Now, if he needs to swim high and you want to get out of the rabbit, he'll just put his head back down and not going over it. Now, as you can see, when he does do his jumps, he grabs that food and he actually has to lift his head back up out of the water to eat it. That's because these guys aren't eating on the water. If they were eating on the water, they'll open their mouth and swallow a lot of water, and it's not really a big damage.
Otherwise, I'm guessing you're in the amazing. Otherwise, I'll have you better. Thank you for this year tomorrow. Just letting you know if you want to wear a towel, you do have a full day. It's